Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the next point, that is population interactions. Last time we have explained about the population regulation. Today we are going to explain next topic or point, that is population interactions. There are two types of population interactions found among the living organism, such as intraspecific population interaction, that is interaction taking place between the members of same species. So this is the interaction between the members of same species called as intraspecific population interaction. And second type is interspecific population interaction, that is interaction between the members of different species. So in case of interspecific population interaction, the interaction occurs between the members of different species. So these are the two type of population interactions, such as intraspecific and interspecific population interaction. The population interactions, the population interactions which are occurring between the members of different species or interspecific population interactions occurs by different ways, such as neutralism, competition, predation, parasitism, commensalism and mutualism. So these are the some of the important type of population interactions. So first we'll explain the neutralism. So this is the neutral type of population interaction. In this case, the partners of both the populations are not affected or harmed. Means there is no any type of harmful effect occurring on any of the member among the populations. So neutralism explains that the partners of both the populations, the partners of both the populations are not affected or harmed. Means there is no any type of interaction, and due to this there is no any harmful effect occurring on the member of populations or two different populations. Then second is competition. The partners of both the populations are affected or inhibited. In case of competition type of interaction, what happens? The partners of both the populations are affected or inhibited. For example, paramecium. Competition is mainly for living space, feeding or breeding grounds, etc. So in case of the interaction between two different species or the populations of different species, there is a competition. In a competition type of population interaction, the partners of both the populations or two different species are affected or inhibited, and its example is paramecium. So, in case of paramecium, competition is mainly for living space or the habitat or the feeding ground and the breeding grounds, etc. Then third type of population interaction, that is predation. In this case, predator is benefited and prey is harmed. So, predators are the usually larger animals or may be carnivore animals, and which are predating or feeding upon its prey organisms or the prey animals, which may be the herbivore animals. And in this case, predator is benefited and prey is harmed. For example, lion and deer. In this case, lion is the carnivore animal and the deer is herbivore animal. So lion serves as a predator, predating upon or the feeding upon the deer, and in this case predator getting benefited, that is lion getting benefited and deer get harmed, or it will get killed. Deer get killed due to the predation of the lion. Then fourth type of population interaction, that is a parasitism. In this case, the parasite is benefited and host is harmed. We know well the host-parasite relationship. Here, the parasite is the organism which is dependent upon other organism for its food, shelter, transport or the space for living. So, whatever the requirements or the needs of the parasite are satisfied by the host organism, and the host organism are thus the organisms which provides support or which satisfy the requirements of the parasite are called as host. So, ultimately in this type of relationship or interaction, that is parasitism, the parasite is benefited and host is always get harm or some disease. For example, Ascaris and man. We know the Ascaris is a roundworm occurring in the intestine of the human being, and host, human being or the man serves as a host. So ultimately the parasite like Ascaris get benefited and gets it its requirement in the form of protection in the small intestine, or it also gets nutrition or the food from the human host. In return, man gets nothing, but man always suffer from certain deficiency disease or a malnutrition. So, in case of parasitism type of population interaction, the parasite is benefited and host is harmed or get loss either in the form of deficiency of the nutrients or certain deficiency diseases, or certain deficiency disease can be developed due to the infection of the intestinal parasite like Ascaris. Then fifth type of population interaction called as commensalism. In this case, one partner is benefited and other partner is neither benefited nor harmed. So this is a loose type of population interaction. It is a loose type of population interaction, and in this case one partner is benefited and can be called as a guest, and the other partner, that is a host, neither benefited nor harmed. For example, the shark and the remora fish. In this example, shark is the larger fish and remora, that is a sucker fish or a small fish which remain attached below the body of shark, just behind the head or gills, and due to this type of relationship or the interaction, the remora fish getting benefited. The partner of the one partner of the population interaction, that is commensalism, one partner is benefited. Here in this example, the remora fish, a small sucker fish, get benefited because it remain attached on the ventral side of the shark and thus get protected and getting transported from one place to other place, and also getting the food, the food material or the food particles which can be released from the gills or the mouth cavity of the shark. So in this case, shark will not be harmed, shark will not getting any benefit, or it is not benefited nor harmed. But रेमोरा फिश, स्मॉल सकर फिश गेट बेनिफिटेड. इन कॉमन सरिज्म वन पार्टनर इज बेनिफिटेड एंड अदर पार्टनर लाइक शार्क इज नाइदर बेनिफिटेड नॉर हार्म. देन लास्ट टाइप ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इंटरैक्शन दैट इज म्यूचुअलिज्म. म्यूचुअलिज्म म्यूचुअस टू म्यूचुअस मीन्स टू एक्सचेंज. म्यूचुअस टू म्यूचुअस मीन्स टू एक्सचेंज. इन दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इंटरैक्शन द ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ द इंटरैक्शन विच आर बिलोंगिंग टू टू डिफरेंट स्पीसीज बट दे इंटरैक्ट इन सच ए वे दैट दे एक्सचेंज और दे इंटरचेंज देयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स. मीन्स दे शोज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ फिजियोलॉजिकल इंटरडिपेंडेंस एंड इन म्यूचुअलिज्म द पार्टनर्स ऑफ बोथ द पॉपुलेशंस आर बेनिफिटेड. मीन्स देर इज अ एक्सचेंज ऑफ नीड्स. देर इज अ एक्सचेंज ऑफ नीड्स बिटवीन द टू ऑर्गेनिजम्स और टू डिफरेंट पॉपुलेशंस. एंड इन दिस टाइप ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इंटरेक्शन द पार्टनर्स ऑफ द पॉपुलेशंस द पार्टनर्स ऑफ द टू डिफरेंट पॉपुलेशंस बोथ आर बेनिफिटेड. बोथ द पार्टनर्स ऑफ द पॉपुलेशंस आर बेनिफिटेड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल हर्मिट क्रैब एंड सी एनेमोन. हर्मिट क्रैब एंड द सी एनेमोन. सो दिस आर द टू मरीन ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर अकरिंग इन द सी वाटर. सो हर्मिट क्रैब एंड द सी एनेमोन. सो हर्मिट क्रैब इज अ क्रस्टेशियन एंड सी एनेमोन इज अ हाइड्रॉइड. सी एनेमोन इज अ हाइड्रॉइड रिमेनिंग अटैच्ड ऑन टू द सेल ऑफ हर्मिट क्रैब. सो इन दिस केस द हर्मिट क्रैब कैरीज सी एनेमोन ऑन इट्स बैक और द कैरापेस. एंड सो सी एनेमोन इज बीइंग कैरीड फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अदर प्लेस. इन रिटर्न द हर्मिट क्रैब गेट्स प्रोटेक्शन. हर्मिट क्रैब गेट्स प्रोटेक्शन. हर्मिट क्रैब गेट्स प्रोटेक्शन ड्यू टू प्रेजेंस ऑफ सी एनेमोन और द हाइड्रॉइड ऑन इट्स बैक और ऑन द डॉर्सल सरफेस और ऑन द कैरापेस और ए सेल ऑफ द हर्मिट क्रैब. एंड इन रिटर्न द हर्मिट क्रैब शेयर्स इट्स फूड टू द सी एनेमोन. सो सी एनेमोन गेटिंग बेनिफिटेड बाई टू वेज. That is, it is carried or transported from one place to other place together with getting nourishment or the food which is shared from the hermit crab. In return, hermit crab gets protection from the enemies in the sea water. In this way, the partners of both the populations are benefited in a mutualism type of population interactions. Example is hermit crab and sea anemone. So there is a exchange of the need from the hermit crab and the sea anemone, and hence both the partners of the population, both the partners of the populations are benefited. Interspecific competitions between populations thus adversely affects the growth and the survival of one or both of the populations involved. So in case of interspecific competitions between the populations or between the two different species affecting the growth and survival of the one or both the partners of the populations involved in the interspecific competitions. Interspecific competitions have tendency to bring about ecological separation of closely related species. So this is again another aspect which can be observed in the nature or in the ecosystem, in the nature or in the ecosystem or in the certain habitat, we can see or we can observe the aspect that is ecological separation. That is called as ecological separation. And this ecological separation can be observed or found among the members of two different populations or interspecific populations. So interspecific competitions have tendency to bring about ecological separation of closely related species. And this concept is called as competition exclusion principle or Gauss principle. So this is just a ecological separation. So as to avoid the competition between the members of different species or the between the populations or two different population. So interspecific competitions mainly shows the ecological separation of the closely related species, and this concept is called as competition exclusion principle. Competition exclusion principle or a Gauss principle. So competition exclusion principle, the competition exclusion principle thus explains, the competition exclusion principle thus explains a natural mechanism found among closely related species to avoid the competition. Means in nature there is a one kind of aspect can be observed or can be found in a closely related species called as competition exclusion principle, and this competition exclusion principle explains the ecological separation. Ecological separations means the members of two different species which are interacting or which are competing with one another can be separated from one another. So this is called as ecological separation or the competition exclusion principle, and this mainly happens in a nature between the two closely related species so as to avoid the competition between the closely related species. And this concept or this type of mechanism is called as competition exclusion principle or Gauss principle. Now we'll explain the Gauss principle or a competition exclusion principle. Competition exclusion principle or Gauss principle. This particular principle experimentally confirmed by the Russian scientist C.F. Gauss in a two species of paramecium. So the Russian scientist, namely C.F. Gauss, who performed an experiment, Russian scientist C.F. Gauss, who performed an experiment in laboratory between the two species of the paramecium to prove or to explain the competition exclusion principle in paramecium. Gauss principle explains that closely related organisms or the species remain ecologically separated. Gauss principle explains that closely related organisms or closely related species remain ecologically separated. In other words, it is the principle of ecological separation. In other words, it is the principle of ecological separation of closely related species due to interspecific competition. It means to avoid the interspecific competitions, closely related species or two closely related species or two closely related organisms usually remain ecologically separated from one another so as to avoid the competition between them. Gauss performed an experiment. Gauss performing this experiment to prove the competition exclusion principle or a Gauss principle, he performed an experiment. While performing an experiment in laboratory, Gauss cultured two species of Paramecium, such as Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia, separately and together. So this is a quite simple experiment performed by Gauss in a laboratory, and while performing this experiment, he cultured or grown two species of Paramecium, such as Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia, in a separate culture and together, or mixed culture. So when cultured separately, when he cultured Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia separately under the same set of controlled environmental conditions or habitat or culture, and fed on the same species of bacteria, both the species of Paramecium flourished and shows the sigmoid growth curves in the laboratory. So this is the first experiment. So while performing the first experiment, the Gauss cultured Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia in two separate cultures with a same set of controlled environmental condition, and fed on the same species of bacteria, means feed and the habitat. The feed and the habitat, or culture and the habitat, both are similar, where the Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia are grown or cultured in the laboratory. So the result of the culture of Paramecium caudatum and the Paramecium aurelia separately showing a good development or proper development of the Paramecium in both the cultures or the both the species. So both the species of the Paramecium, that is Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia, get flourished, means where they grows and multiply fast, showing the sigmoid growth curves in the laboratory. And when both the species cultured together, and when both the species, that is Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia, cultured or grown together in a same culture, only one species, that is Paramecium aurelia, survived and Paramecium caudatum not survived. Means when Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia cultured separately in the laboratory, they shows their normal development, or they shows their normal development or multiplication or establishment in the separate cultures. Means in separate cultures in laboratory, both species Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia develops normally or properly and get flourished and shows normal sigmoid growth curves in the laboratory. But when both the species are cultured together and forced to compete for the same feed or same type of bacteria, Paramecium aurelia, only Paramecium aurelia gets survived, and Paramecium caudatum not survived, or the number or the population of the Paramecium caudatum declines or decreased. The survival of Paramecium aurelia, the survival of Paramecium aurelia is due to faster growth than Paramecium caudatum. The survival of Paramecium aurelia is due to faster growth than Paramecium caudatum. Thus, Paramecium aurelia is more successful. Thus, Paramecium aurelia is more successful in competing for the limited food supply. Thus, the Paramecium aurelia is more successful in competing for the limited food supply. This also indicates that the two species of Paramecium cannot live together in a same culture. This also indicates that the two species of the Paramecium cannot live together in a same culture. This represents the good example of competition exclusion principle. Competition exclusion principle. So, in a same set of culture, in a same set of culture or controlled conditions of the environment, and same feed, that is a similar type of bacteria, when fed separately in a separate cultures in a laboratory, both species, that is Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia, develops normally in a separate cultures in a same set of controlled environmental conditions, or the same feed, that is a similar type of bacteria, in a separate cultures they grows normally or establish or flourish or multiply normally. But when both species, that is Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia, cultured or grown in the same culture or in a same set of controlled conditions of the environment in the same culture together, means there is a mixed culture of Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia. So, in a mixed culture, or when the two species of the Paramecium cultured together, grown together on the same set of culture or same set of controlled environmental condition and the feed, that is bacteria, only one species, that is Paramecium aurelia gets survive, and Paramecium caudatum fails to survive. It means two different species of the Paramecium cannot live together in a same culture. So this is indicating that the one species, that is Paramecium aurelia, grows fast, or which compete successfully with Paramecium caudatum, where Paramecium aurelia grows, feeds fast, grows fast and multiply fast or compete fast with the Paramecium caudatum. And Paramecium caudatum cannot live or survive with the Paramecium aurelia. So, this is the competition exclusion principle explained by the Gauss, Russian scientist C.F. Gauss, who performed the simple experiment by culturing the two different species of the Paramecium, such as Paramecium aurelia and Paramecium caudatum, separately and together in separate cultures at same laboratory conditions or same feed. They grows normally, they flourish normally in the separate cultures. Both the species of the Paramecium grows normally or flourish or multiply properly in a separate cultures in the laboratory. But when the same species are grown or cultured in the same set of controlled conditions of the environment or the culture and the feed, only Paramecium Aurelia can survive and Paramecium caudatum cannot survive in the same culture. Means this indicates that Paramecium aurelia compete. This indicates that Paramecium aurelia compete successfully in a culture with a Paramecium caudatum and get flourished or get developed fast than the Paramecium caudatum, and the Paramecium caudatum cannot survive in the same culture with the Paramecium aurelia. This type of principle or this type of mechanism is called as competition exclusion principle or a Gauss principle. This is the figure showing the growth curves. These are the growth curves or the figures showing growth curves, which are explained or approved by the Gauss to explain or to prove the competition exclusion principle in the Paramecium caudatum. In figure 3.8, Gauss principle, Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia in a separate culture showing sigmoid growth. In the upper figures, the figures, upper figure, that is figure 3.8. Figure 3.8 shows Gauss principle, that is in figure A, that is Paramecium caudatum, and in figure B, Paramecium aurelia, which are grown in a separate culture and laboratory conditions or same set of laboratory conditions, same set of environmental conditions or the culture in a separate containers, they shows the normal development or the growth and representing the sigmoid growth curve. So in figure A, the figure A shows a sigmoid curve representing the population growth or the population density, and which is plotted against the time. Population density of the Paramecium caudatum is drawn or plotted against the time and showing a sigmoid curve. Similarly, figure B shows the sigmoid growth curve of the population density against the time plotted to explain the growth pattern of the Paramecium aurelia. So in first two figures, that is figure A and figure B of figure 3.8, shows the sigmoid growth curves in a Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia in a separate cultures. In a lower figure 3.9, Gauss principle explains or illustrate the Paramecium caudatum is eliminated, or there is a decline or decrease in a number of the individuals of the Paramecium caudatum in a mixed culture. So in figure 3.9, we can see the Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia when cultured or grown in the same culture, in a same culture and fed on the same type of bacteria, shows the sigmoid growth curve only in case of Paramecium aurelia, or the Paramecium aurelia shows the sigmoid growth curve or the normal growth pattern and compete successfully. Paramecium aurelia compete successfully or grows successfully, growing fast in the mixed culture. In case of Paramecium caudatum, in case of Paramecium caudatum, which cannot survive, which cannot live in a mixed culture, and thus it fails to undergo its growth and multiplication, but the number of the individuals of the Paramecium caudatum declines or decrease in a mixed culture when grown in the same culture. So this figure shows these two figures, that is upper two and lower one, upper and lower figures 3.8 and 3.9 shows the population exclusion, population, the sorry, competition exclusion principle, competition exclusion principle or the Gauss principle. So in upper two, the separate cultures of the Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia showing the sigmoid growth curve in a separate cultures, and when grown or cultured in a same culture, that is a mixed or grown together, cultured together, Paramecium aurelia grows fast and flourish, but the Paramecium caudatum fails to flourish or to grow or to multiply, but its number declines in the mixed culture, indicating that the Paramecium caudatum cannot live together with the Paramecium aurelia in mixed culture. But in a same set of conditions of the control environmental conditions or the feed or bacteria, they can grow separately and they flourish or they multiply in a separate cultures in a laboratory, but cannot survive together. So one of the species get eliminated. This is the competition exclusion principle proposed by Gauss. So today we shall stop here. Next time we will continue with a remaining topic, that is the measurement of population density. Measurement of the population density, that we will explain next time. So today we will stop here with the population interactions and the Gauss principle. Thank you.